It's April, and this is the Library Roadshow. On the show today, food, frolic, and edible books. Welcome to the April edition of the Library Roadshow. I'm Mary Stein, and this is a production of your East Baton Rouge Parish Library System. This month, the library is brought to you by the letters T, U, and V, and T stands for taste. So much is going on at the library, and a lot of it is centered around food and our One Book, One Community series, Celebrating Tasting History by YouTube personality Max Miller. Max will join us in person on April 20th, and there are plenty more culinary programs on the table in April. Poet laureate Mona Lisa Saloy presents Red Beans and Rice Liqueurs. Ann Milnick of Red Stick Spice Company will share tea and literature, and The Advocate's Jan Risher hits the airwaves with her own YouTube videos. The Red Stick Farmers Market returns to the main library for their Tuesday afternoon markets, and our virtual author talks feature Smithsonian American Table, the foods, people, and innovations that feed us. The kids are getting into the kitchen, too. The theme for National Library Week aligns with our own theme this year, Invest in You, and we invite you to really lean in to all the fabulous programs, tools, and resources we offer to help you upcycle yourself. Our Libraries Change Lives selection for April features local author Marion Griffin, and of course, we're also bringing back Authors Row at the Jones Creek Regional Branch this month. The 14th annual Pride Cheneyville Community History Festival is a high school reunion, and we'll celebrate spring with the Baton Rouge Concert Band and Tim the Magician. We also invite you to strum along with the ukulele man and carefully gaze into the sun for the solar eclipse. During Finding Fortunes, we'll host LPB for a behind-the-scenes look at how they hosted the nationally acclaimed Antiques Roadshow in Baton Rouge last year. And our deep dive into the newsletter highlights some resources that will help you with your treasure hunt. Read all about it in this month's issue of The Source, in print and online at ebrpl.com.
Free access to books, audio, and library resources are just a few of the benefits available to you when you get a library card. Need free access to a computer? You get that. Want free access to premium digital resources like Mango Languages and lynda.com? You get that. Need to book a meeting space? You get that. Heck, you can even check out a telescope or use a digital printer with your library card. If you live in East Baton Rouge Parish, pick up your free library card from your local branch library today. Premium access to everything the library system has to offer is waiting for you.
Patrons have made great use of the Learning Express platform to help them prepare for a broad range of civil service tests, ACT tests, and more. But it's important to keep our eyes open for new resources that perhaps cover other topics. Mometrix fills the bill. It's time to find out more in the digital download.
Mometrix offers a wealth of online test preparation resources. It includes thousands of study guides, practice tests, and flashcard titles for over 1,500 different exams. Practice tests and flashcards are interactive and can be completed online. Study guide books are always available, can be read online, and also allow printing for offline study. Mometrix includes a library of videos that teach and supplement the test preparation on numerous topics. For example, short micro-learning videos that act as a math refresher. For educational tests, you'll find content for the ACT, SAT, GRE, and MCAT. Other test topic areas include civil service, real estate, healthcare, construction, teaching, and more. Mometrix works hard to keep materials aligned with the latest exam standards. Updates are pushed out in real time, ensuring that users have access to the most up-to-date materials. You'll find Mometrix and our other test prep resource, Learning Express, in the digital library at ebrpl.com.
The Mometrix platform offers some high-end testing topics. It even has flashcards to help you prepare for the project management test. Really great for young professionals who are trying to get ahead. Let's shift gears now and go beyond the stacks.
My name is Jessica McDaniel. I'm the Community Programming and Outreach Librarian at the East Baton Rouge Parish Library. We're here at the main library at Goodwood to celebrate our One Book, One Community series with a kickoff party. Here at the kickoff party, we have live music by RJ and Zydeco Smooth. We have free food, courtesy of Popple, patrons of the public library, and Odom's Kitchen. And we also have a lot of community organizations here to engage with the public and talk about what they can do for them. This year's One Book, One Community selection is Tasting History by Max Miller. It's a cookbook, but it's also a narrative that goes through the history of food through different recipes. So you can engage with the book through cooking the recipes or learning a little about the history of different ingredients, different dishes from around the world. The One Book, One Community series, it's a way to engage people with library resources, it's a way to promote literacy, and it's a way to connect the community with each other through the wonderful themes of the books that we choose. This is a kickoff party. We're kicking off 2 months of wonderful programming at the main library and at all the library branches near you, celebrating food, history, vlogging, all sorts of wonderful things for you to engage with your library.
Delightful, delectable, delicious, maybe even delirious. How many words can you use to describe our One Book, One Community kickoff? Tasting History kicked off with a big bang at the main library in March, and we had a blast. Check it out. Stay right there. After the break, Cynthia Watanabe joins me for a chat right here on the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that preparing children to enter kindergarten is good for us all. That's why we created Press Start, an early learning initiative that provides a free activity booklet every month that explores early literacy skills through play and interaction at home. Get a library card. Sign up for Press Start at ebrpl.com/kids.
There are 16 million children struggling with hunger in America. That's 1 in 5 daughters, sons, neighbors, and classmates who don't know where their next meal is coming from. Yet billions of pounds of good food go to waste every year. It's time we do something about it. Feeding America is a nationwide network of food banks that helps provide meals to millions of kids and families in need. Visit feedingamerica.org to help them feed even more. Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America.
You're watching the April edition of the Library Roadshow, everything you need to know about your local library system. Now, we've been working behind the scenes on a very big project, getting ready to roll out up to 130,000 new library cards for kids. Cynthia Watanabe runs the circulation department for the library system, and she has been involved in every step of the way. So, okay, Cynthia, what's on the table for new cards for 130,000 students?
Well, in addition to our standard card, which students and children have had for years, that can check out books and use the computers, we have two new versions. One is the restricted card. We call that our bookshelf card. And that one, they can only check out if they're children from the juvenile collection. If they're tweens or teens, only from juvenile and teens. And they do not use the computers with that card.
Okay, so that's big because kids come in to the library. Cards are used for more than checking books out.
They're
used to access the computers. They're used to get free prints every day. They're used to access the digital library and a few other things as well, to earn your badge for making, all kinds of things. So this new kids bookshelf card is restricted.
Yes, it is.
And we have them for each kind of age as well.
We do. We have them for kids, for tweens, and for teens.
And then we have another kind of card that we're calling the Explorer card. Here's our little bear exploring the world.
Now, this one's fun because the kids can access kids collection, teen collection, and the adult collection. So if you have a reader that's reading above grade level, then that's the card to go with, because they would be able to access the collections that are above their age group.
Yeah. So we have lots of choices, actually. We have we have 12 choices.
Yes, we do.
Because we also have student e-cards that are rolled out through public schools, private schools, all over the parish. Now, this is not rocket science. What do parents have to do? Because this is the law. This is the new thing. This is not the library's idea. We were fine. But there is a law that it was enacted last year, went on the books, and we must comply by June 1st. So what do parents have to do by June 1st?
Well, they can come into the library anytime when they want to check out a book and say they need to update their card. And they need to tell us what type of card they want. Do they want to keep the standard card? Do they want the restricted card? Or do they want the unrestricted card? And then we'll make a note in their account. They can do all of their children at the same time. Mm-hmm. If they're not in the library, then they can go on our website, ebrpl.com, and go to parental consent, and they can fill out a short form, and we will update it for them. And when they fill out that form, we'll also update their student cards.
That's great, because yes, students need access to the digital library.
Yes, and it's really easy. It only takes a minute more of their time. Mm-hmm. And then when it comes to June 1st, then their cards will not be blocked.
Right in time for summer reading, when the kids have required summer reading to do, and then, of course, we have so many programs and activities. Now, why are we doing this?
Well, this is part of the law, LA 25:225, that required us to have more options for the students, to give the parents more control over what their children are reading and viewing.
Now, of course, we always want parents to have control over what their children are reading, viewing, doing, and participating in the library. And for that reason, children under the age of 9 are not allowed in the library without that parental unit or some governing body, some appropriate guardian of their actions. But we've always wanted parents to pay attention to what's going on in their children's reading journey. And we want parents to ask staff, because not every book is for every child. Sometimes it's interest, sometimes it's maturity, sometimes it's the sheer volume of information and the level of the information that they're receiving on any particular topic. So we want parents and children, mm-hmm, including our teens,
yes,
to feel comfortable asking the staff for guidance to help them get into the right book for them at that time. So how do they reach you? What is that email for them to?
It's ebrplcards@ebrpl.com.
So ebrpl cards, all smashed together.
All smashed together.
At ebrpl.com, which is the same thing as our website. Okay, well, you and your staff are examples of grace under pressure. We'll be rooting for you to get 130,000 cards done by June 1st, but if not, it's not the end of the world. Whenever a parent comes in with that child, they can update then.
Certainly.
Okay.
We're happy to do it.
All right. Well, after the break, we'll see author Adam J. Smith. Plus, we'll check out the C.W. Austin Learning Disabilities Conference. All that and more coming up next on the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that supporting the education of students is good for us all. That's why we provide access to live, in-person, online tutoring through Homework Louisiana. Make available free test preparation tools through Learning Express. Plus, reference tools for all ages. Get a library card. Get free education at ebrpl.com/homework help.
My biggest fear in the middle of my addiction was that I would never be able to get over it and that my kids wouldn't have a father. I started thinking, you know what? This isn't my story. For the longest time, fear held me back from ultimately being who I wanted to. I had to become a better man to be a better father. It's important to me that my kids are empowered and truly believe that if they can think it, they can do it.
Welcome back to the April edition of the Library Roadshow. Since 1996, Madisonville, Louisiana has been home to my next guest, author Adam J. Smith. Music was Adam's first love. His writing career began at age 11 when he wrote his first song. Since then, he's written over 900 songs, hundreds of poems, and several books. Adam joins me now by phone to discuss his latest book entitled Your Honor. Hey, Adam, how long have you been writing?
I'm author Adam J. Smith, and I have been writing my whole life since I was 11 years old. In that time, I failed many times before I was successful. My first book, Tales of Miscellany, really began as just a fun hobby, and then it ended up turning into a bestseller at Barnes & Noble, and that's really what got me going.
What is this new book, Your Honor, about?
My book, Your Honor, is about a small Louisiana town that gets taken over by a corrupt leader, and the townspeople struggle to try and take their town back from them, and they face a lot of obstacles along the way.
What inspired you to write this book?
I just love to write. I'm always trying to write something new and exciting. I try to write in different genres. Your Honor is a fun book of mystery and adventure and a lot of adversity that I think hits home with a lot of people.
Do you have any advice to share with other aspiring writers?
As far as advice I would give to people, I'd say never give up. Don't stop writing. And always review it and write it again until it's perfect. You're going to write a lot of stuff that you don't like and a lot of bad books on the way to being successful. And all those books will play a role in creating your bestseller.
How can our viewers learn more about you and your work?
Viewers can contact me and see my work at my website, which is booksbyadamjsmith.com. They can also find me on Facebook. My Facebook page is Books by Adam J. Smith. Thank you.
Thanks, Adam. Let's inspire all of our viewers to put down their own tunes or turn a phrase for some rhyme time. It's so important to the library to meet people where they are and help them find the resources they need at the very time that they need them. And we'd love to support other helping organizations, especially those helping some of our most vulnerable populations. It was our privilege to welcome the C.W. Austin Learning Disabilities Conference to the library this month. What an asset to the community.
Evaluations. One question that I get a lot is about the difference between a Section 504 plan and an individualized education program. And one of the biggest differences is that these two types of supports, if you will, are governed by two different laws.
So we are the Greater Baton Rouge Learning Disability Coalition, and we're a group of volunteers who put on professional development for parents and providers who are working to make the world better for people with learning disabilities.
Thank you so much for coming. My name is Georgia Ann Meir, and I'm the president of the Greater Baton Rouge Learning Disability Coalition.
So today we're at the Goodwood Library in Baton Rouge, and we're excited to kick off the C.W. Austin Learning Disability Conference, where we're inviting parents and providers who work with kids with learning disabilities so that they can have a better understanding of the tools that are available to make the world a better place for folks with learning disabilities.
We are so proud to have you guys here and that you care about our kids with learning disabilities. It's 1 in 5 of the population. So even if you came here just for CEUs, we're still going to be able to give you some great information that will help you with anybody in your life who is having some problems in school.
So this is our kickoff for our annual Learning Disability Conference. And we kick off with an in-person event where we will feature five local psychologists, and they'll be talking about different aspects of learning disabilities, including how to talk to a kid about their learning disabilities, how to understand evaluations, medications, all kinds of different ways that you can help people from learning disabilities.
If you haven't registered for our virtual conference, we would love for you to participate in that too. And you can register at ldhelp.org.
We are so excited to be in this beautiful space. I hadn't been in the room until yesterday, and we walked in, we were like, wow, because we have met in all kind of different places. And so we were just thrilled to partner with the library to have them, you know, when you're working with the library, you know you're going to have a quality experience. And we're a nonprofit, we're all volunteers, our event is free. So being able to use our community space and not have to pay $1 million for it is wonderful.
Some of you have come every year, and some of you are new. And so we're so glad to have you. And again, we all can make the world a better place if we help our kids with learning disabilities.
So we have a website. It's called ldhelp.org. So you can register for the virtual, and it's going to go on all the way till April 7th. So we're excited to be able to offer this to everybody 24/7. So you can go on, register, and watch any a la carte presentation that just interests you, that will help you either in your work or as a parent, or if you have a learning disability, you might be interested in learning more about it. We do have CEUs available for social workers, for speech language pathologists and counselors. And then also we have general certificates for any other disciplines that are interested in collecting their CEUs and who care about our kids with learning disabilities.
Stay right there. You're watching the Library Roadshow.
The East Baton Rouge Parish Library believes that making things is good for us all. That's why we have makerspaces at four locations and a 3D printing service at the main library. The makerspaces have a variety of tools and equipment to enable both creative and practical projects. This includes 3D printers, sewing machines, audio-visual gear, and much more. Get a library card. Get free access to makerspaces at ebrpl.com/makerspaces.
Hey world, I have a quick message. It's about safe driving. All right, let's go. Anytime you're driving, have the seatbelt buckled tight, both hands on the wheel and your phone out of sight. When not in your hand trying to text somebody back, because if you do, your car might get smacked. The moral of the story, just put your phone down. The people on the road will stay safe and sound. Put your phone down, put your phone down. People on the road will stay safe and sound. Yeah.
You're watching the April edition of the Library Roadshow, a production of your East Baton Rouge Parish Library System. Ah, spring, when a young man's fancy turns to frolic on St. Paddy's Day. And how about some Celtic tunes to get you started? It was fun sounds all around with Lady Chops and Madame Dulcimer when they toured the library system with their Celtic concert.
My name is Lady Chops, and I'm here with Madame Dulcimer, and we're here at East Baton Rouge Parish Libraries this week playing our Celtic concert. Madame Madam Dulcimer and I have known each other for a long time and played music together for the last few years. And she is a hammered dulcimer national champion. And I've been in the off-Broadway theater show Stomp for 10 years. And so the two of us got together and it's quite the pairing. There's a little comedy involved. There's a lot of really high quality music, and there's a lot of percussion and fun for everyone. We're doing our Celtic program in Ascension Parish Library this past week and EBR Libraries, and we have a lot of people coming out wearing their green. They're ready to celebrate St. Patrick's Day. They're ready to do a little jig, and we are here to entertain them with so many different instruments. I have at least 20 plus percussion instruments, and then Madam Dulcimer is playing not only the hammered dulcimer, but she is also a classically trained pianist. And so if you want to see the arts, you want to see live concert music that is of awesomeness, then come to EBR Libraries. Yeah, we'll be playing the Bowron, which is a Celtic drum, and it has been around a long time. It is inspired by the tambourine, but it's bigger, and it has that driving drum sound that you hear in the movies, you know, whenever you're watching Mel Gibson charging it. And we also have the hammered dulcimer. Now, Madam Dulcimer has 111 string instrument that most people never will see played in person, much less played by a national champion, master of the instrument. And so it's a unique opportunity for Louisiana to come out and see this instrumentation. I am so thankful for libraries because they have actually given me the opportunity to be a full-time musician. In the summer, a lot of times for summer reading, I will come along and play with kids, with my kids' programming. And then for Christmas, Madam Dulcimer and I came here and did our Christmas program. And so it really can be a year-round event where live music is being brought to patrons at libraries. And they can come see the shows for free. And we get to be musicians. So it's an awesome team that the libraries and musicians and artists can be to bring this to communities.
All the toes were tapping. You can bet we'll hear from Lady Chops and Madam Dulcimer again. And now for today's contest. Visit the library's Facebook page at facebook.com/ebrpl. Even though the contest is over, you can still show off your creativity with a photo of your own edible book. That's facebook.com/ebrpl, and while you're there, enjoy. We are not your grandfather's library anymore. What's coming up on the Library Roadshow in May? Soul food. Thanks so much for joining us on the Library Roadshow, and remember, your East Baton Rouge Parish Library is open 7 days a week at each and every one of 14 branches, plus 24/7 on the web. Check us out at ebrpl.com.